have to cut low right over there because
we'll be right back. Thank you.
right there, you gotta be careful not to make the tires spin, because that's gonna tear up the grass. See, like right there, it's struggling for traction. Stegosaurus. My one headphone's about to, I think it's blown because it is so distorted. But this is like an old pair of Apple headphones. This came with back when I got my old iPod. Oh, there's always grass right in there. I'm listening to Mine Turtle. Okay. Let's do this. The ground's still soggy. So no matter how hard you try, you're gonna tear up the ground. Like my friend says, you can try, but you're gonna fail. I mean, it's gonna happen. You know, it's just a part of mowing, you know? The ground's wet. Mowers tear up the ground, you know, it happens. Evengrow does it, I do it. One of my buddies called Creek the Freak Lawn Care does it. I love watching his videos, only he's more of a pro than I am. But it's gonna happen. Nothing you can do about it. You can try, but oh well. And I mow these guys' lawn on a weekly basis, so they never complain to me about it looking bad at all. I took a break because my mom stopped by Starbucks and got me a little treat, and I decided to go home and eat that real quick because I don't know how long it would get before it got all, you know, like stale and hard and stuff. They're little doggies. I'm being barked at. Okay. So I want to explain this lawn real quick. If you saw my flooding video, you saw this was the section that I cut. It floods a lot. And I kind of did some mud strips, and if you don't know what those are, I'll link it in the video. Check out my good friend, Greek the Freak Lawn Care. He kind of explains that. I cut this part slightly lower because while I'm gone, it's supposed to rain a lot. And I don't know how much rain we're supposed to get, but it's just that there's a chance of rain a couple days while I'm gone. So I don't, with all the, since this area floods so much, it grows faster than the other parts of the yard. And I haven't recorded it in the past, but if you've ever seen me mow this lawn, it's crazy. And then this patch right here is always muddied, and it's so hard not to tear up the grass. Even with Squirt, the non-self-propelled lawnmower. So, I mean, look at this, my feet slip. So I double cut this part, I raised my mower back to the original height, and you can see the grass left behind from the last time I mowed. When I started, it was cloudy, and next thing I know, it starts raining, so the grass gets all wet, and I didn't want to leave the lawn half done, so I went ahead and kept mowing. And it kind of got clumped up, so I came back the next day and remowed it, but a lot of those clumps are still left behind, and it's no big, they said it was no big deal, so I'm like, okay, so, oh well, that's why I'm bagging it this week, so, let's get back to it. But I just had a total brain fart and thought I forgot to empty the bag. That was a horrible pull. Mowed that middle because I couldn't tell how well the strip was, so I didn't want there to be like a patch of missing grass. One thing I like about this mower is that's all you empty the bag. And for those of you who don't know, this is an all-wheel drive lawnmower made by Craftsman. Really awesome. Briggs & Stratton. 725 horsepower. I love it. This is replacing my red Craftsman that I used to own. And I've had really good luck with Craftsman, so she's a keeper for sure. And the nice thing is, I kept the old bags from the old Craftsman and the other Craftsman I had, so I have backup bags. So if I ever mow in the rain or really wet grass, I can use one of those and not the really nice one with the all-wheel drive on the side. Need to fix up my JS46 soon. I miss using it. That was a great mower. If it wasn't for that tree root, I don't know, it would still be running. I'm just kind of frustrated on my part that that happened, but like you said, fix it up. It depends on how much money it is. If not, I might give it to a friend of mine who fixes those things. That JS46 is one of the best John Deere mowers I've ever used. The old JS30 gave me so much problems. Nice. Very nice. There's a dead bird. That's disgusting. And the cool thing about this mower is, if you haven't seen the video for it, there's height adjustments, and you can do it via the handlebar. So this thing's really quiet, I love it. I'm gonna recommend this to my church, because they make two kinds of this. Because my church has really uneven terrains in some parts, and we do have some built mowers, but I think this would be good for some really uneven spots, so. So, see, there's the lowest adjustment. This is the highest one. This is the where I have it, so. And the washer port. I really don't wash it as much when I'm mowing, especially like right now, because the grass just sticks to the inside. So what I like to do is I like to get all my lawns done, and I might come back and get that spot. I like to do is get all my lawns done, and then I'll wash them off. But I don't like to wash them off at the end of every day, because if I'm just gonna use it the next day, if it's gonna get all messy, I really don't see the point. You can see this, all the stuff on the side, you know? Okay. If you remember the last time I did this, I was using Squirt, and Squirt was having all these issues. He has since been looked at, and has fresh oil and everything. Okay. I kind of like to do it, because I got a lot of dislikes on that. So I kind of like to do a video now and kind of show you what it... yeah. I try my best to make sure this lawn looks nice. Then I'm going to do that one and another one. So, here we go. Did I get more dog poop on the wheel? Sure smells like it. This thing's peeling off. Bummer. have to dog crap again. Dang it. Yep. Okay, I'm gonna save the rest of the space for the other lawns I'm doing, so I'll see you guys later. What's up, guys? If you can hear me, I just got stung about 10 minutes ago by a dumbass bee. I was mowing, and it was like all of a sudden I felt like someone was pushing a hot needle into my skin. I looked down, and it was stinging me in my sock, and it hurts right now, but I went home and told my parents. They're gonna run out and grab a bite stick. I thought we had one, but we don't. They put some cream on it, and I put ice on it. It still hurts a lot, but I'm gonna bite the bullet and keep going. Sometimes that's all you really can do. But it hurts a lot, but I don't want to get behind, so I'm gonna finish this lawn to the other lawn I have to do all today. And then do three tomorrow, and do a couple more on Friday. So, yeah, ooh, shoot. Truly hate bees. Like Dave's farm, I hate them. I know they make honey, but still, I hate them. I hate their guts. And today only goes to prove how much I hate them. And I've done this lawn so many times. This is the first time I've ever gotten stung mowing the lawn. That I've done on a weekly basis. I have never noticed any beehive activities, but we're getting into the season now. I'm not used to mowing this lawn. So, ugh. Fight the pain. thank goodness I didn't have my camera on because I was doing a lot of swearing because it hurt. And there was one that landed on my stomach. And the fact that I'm wearing a really brightly colored shirt makes me an easy target. Ugh. Dumbass bee. Waterfall.